JCC yogis. My name's Kristina. Welcome back to our virtual yoga studio. Today I'll be leading you through a nice simple vinyasa. This class is going to be great for anybody looking to just come back to the basics and build their roots, nice strong foundational poses. Hi JCC yogis, my name is Kristina. Welcome back to our virtual yoga studio. Today I'll be leading you through a nice simple vinyasa flow. This class is going to be great for anybody looking to just come back to their basics and really build their roots with some foundational poses. We will start by going through the vinyasa and holding each asana or pose for about 5 breaths. This will allow us to really sink in and gain all those benefits from that pose. As we make it through both sides, we'll start to flow breath to movement. And we'll move through this vinyasa one time. And based on your practice and how you're feeling, definitely at the end of this video, feel free to pause it and flow through as many times as you need before moving into the cool down. That being said, all you'll need today is your mat and something cozy on. We'll get started in a nice comfortable seat. Start to close your eyes. Just arrive in your space. Maybe take some open mouth exhales as you settle in. Feel the tailbone rooted into the earth. And feel the energy come up and out the crown of the head with each inhale. Letting the shoulders relax away from the ears. Really finding your center. You can start to deepen the breath. Just drawing more inward with each breath cycle. Begin to bring hands to heart center, Anjali Mudra. Gently bow chin to chest. This is the mudra of compassion. So while you're here, I invite you to just take a moment to invite in some self-gratitude, some love, and appreciation for yourself. Can set an intention here, or just be grateful for stepping onto your mat. Any words of encouragement to fuel your practice and make you feel light, hold on to that. Begin to open the eyes. Let the hands rest down onto the knees. We'll take some seated cat-cows. So we're just going to be taking little shifts with the pelvis. So you can start to rock. So you can kind of just get a little bit of a feeling of what that is like. Just moving forward and back, maybe side to side. Just finding your center in your pelvis. Good. We'll start to find that neutral seat. At the bottom of your exhale, start to draw the elbows down and inhale, lift into the chest. Gaze rises, squeeze down through the elbows. almost hugging them towards your side body as you lift into the heart. You can imagine your shoulder blades making a nice little shelf behind your heart space, really pushing and encouraging that open heart here. We'll take one more breath cycle, really pull against the knees as you squeeze tight. And on your exhale, we'll start to shift back and round forward. Head is going towards the navel. And you can push, you can sort of push the knees away here. Really drop into the head. Feel nice and open behind your back and behind the shoulder blades. Nice and open and broad, breathing into that space behind your heart. And on your next inhale, we'll start to draw the gaze up. Chest rise. Exhale, round it forward. Really exaggerate these movements. Inhale, the chest lifts. Exhale, round it forward. Empty out all your air. Just a few more cycles here, moving with your breath. Starting to finish up and even out. We'll meet in a neutral position, seated once again. The shoulders rest down, beautiful. And then we'll meet in a tabletop position. Shoulders are gonna stack over wrist, hips over knees. Take a few moments to just take any little movement that feels good to you here. Maybe looking back at the feet, opening up through the side body. And as you feel good, we'll start to find some engagement and work through the core. So, starting to find some lift in the core. You should be able to lift your hand off the ground and feel nice and strong and stable in your center body. Take a breath here, start to find that balance. And as you're ready, we're gonna extend the left foot out and back. So you can imagine you're pressing your foot against the wall. That's how much energy is going into straightening through the knee and engaging into the core. So try not to open up through the hip or tuck down and sink into the right side. Really engage through the left side of your abs, your side body. And if you want more of a challenge here for your balance, start to extend through the left side. Beautiful. Pull your chest through. Nice deep inhale. Draw the toes down, thumb to the sky. And exhale, we're going to crunch the elbow to the knee. Inhale, we extend. And if your arm isn't up, you'll just be crunching knee to nose. Continuing to move. Inhales, extend. Exhales, crunch it in. Inhale, extend. Exhale, crunch it in. Last one. Inhale. Exhale, crunch. This time, let's hold here. So take a breath cycle. Feel the belly inflate on the inhale. Exhale, really empty out all that air. Good. One more reach. Extend. Inhale, nice and long. And we'll drop through center. Take any little movements here. And then we'll start to work the left side. As you're ready, we'll start to extend through your right leg.
Really engaging in through the abdomen, the left oblique. Again, trying not to compromise and sink into the left hip joint. Stay nice and active. Option to extend through your left arm. Inhale for length. Exhale, crunch it in. Inhale, extend. Exhale, crunch it out. Inhale, reach. Exhale, crunch. Inhale, stay engaged. Don't lift into the hip. Exhale, crunch it in. Last one. Inhale, find your extension. Exhale, crunch and hold. Take a breath cycle. Feel the belly lift and inflate. Exhale, empty out all that air. Inhale, extend, find some length, and drop through table. As you're ready, you feel good, we're gonna take just a couple little wrist stretches, just preparing our wrists for some push-ups, some chaturanga, planks as well, and just getting our muscles ready. So we'll flip the top of the hand down to the mat. Shift the hips back to the side. Just finding that sweet spot. And switch it out. Stay with your breath. Good. And then as you're ready, tuck toes under, send hips high, downward facing dog. Walk your dog out, press one heel to the floor, bend into the opposite knee, and switch it out. Stay nice and active here, in through the elbow creases. Trying not to hyperextend into the forearms. And as you're ready, we'll come to our standing static dog. Beautiful. Press the chest to the floor, lift into the tailbone. On your inhale, the gaze will shift forward. Exhale, step or hop your way forward. We'll take a nice gentle forward fold here, taking whatever stance with your feet. Some people like to come hip distance. Let the head relax down and bring the stretch into the hamstrings. So finding a slightly lengthened hamstrings here. Tilt up into the tailbone, shift the weight into the front of your mat. On your inhale, we'll lift and do a halfway lift. Press and pull against the legs. Pull that heart forward. Take one more breath here. Really extend into your hamstrings. And exhale, round it forward. Beautiful. Inhale, we'll rise all the way up. Come through standing. Reach to the sky and down through heart center. Good. Take a moment here. Just come back to that intention you set at the beginning of your practice. And just let yourself know it's going to be time to put in some work. Start to open the eyes. Inhale, exhale. Extend through the arms. Drop down into the shoulders as you spin the pinkies in towards one another to really lock them down into place. Lift into the heart. And exhale, we'll sit low into a chair pose. Fire up into the belly. Send your weight back into the heels. You should be able to wiggle the toes. Beautiful. We'll take just a few more breaths here. Sit a little bit lower. Lift in the heart just a little bit more as you send those hips a little lower. Sit into that chair a little deeper. Inhale, we lift into the heart. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, press into the hands. One big step into our plank. We'll take a few breaths here. Pull your heart forward. Really grip into your mat. Activate into the glutes, the quads. Beautiful. And as you're ready, we'll take our first chaturanga push-up. So exhale, elbows squeeze in towards the side body. We'll take a tricep push-up. So exhale to lower down. Inhale, shift your weight forward. Upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Nice deep inhale. Open mouth, exhale. Shake your head yes. Shake your head no. We'll start to work into the rest of our flow. Inhale, extend through the right leg. Take a moment here. Draw your right hip down, just like we practice in those crunches. And exhale, crunch it forward, knee to nose. Inhale, extend. Exhale, we're gonna tap the knee to the right elbow. Inhale, extend. Exhale, cross it over, tap your left elbow. Inhale, extend. Take a moment here. Find your three-legged dog once again. And one big breath. Exhale, crunch it forward, step it through. We're in our low lunge, and we'll drop into the back knee. Option to tuck those toes or to drop them down, whatever is best for you. We'll start to sink in to our modified crescent. Feel a nice stretch in through the front of your quads, your groin. Option to lift through the arms. Taking whatever arm variation is good for you. Really find some strength to complement the flexibility here. So as easy as it is to really sink into your full flexibility, find some strength, find some heat. We'll take one more breath here. On your exhale, start to plant through your left hand. Right arm reaches up as you take a nice twist. Looking up to the sky, drawing the shoulder down and flat against the back. Drawing your right hip down and back as well, coming in line with the left hip. Checking in with that knee, making sure that it's not hyperextending and going over the ankle. Keep pressing through your hand, finding that strength. Exhale, empty out all your air. And on your inhale, we'll rise into a twisted crescent. Sink a little bit deeper, shift your weight up and back, pulling through your right arm. energy moving up the spine and out the crown of the head as you sink lower, creating one big long line of energy upwards. Trying to avoid a diagonal line, really sticking with that straight line. Beautiful. One more breath. Sink a little bit deeper. And then start to drop into your back arm, pressing your palm against your sacrum, and then lifting up and back through your left side. Beautiful, yogis. Keep sinking into it. Breathing into the base of the belly. Beautiful, and big transition. Exhale, cartwheel your hands all the way down to frame the foot. Extend the left knee up, and then extend your right foot up and back, three-legged dog. Take a breath here. And on your exhale, start to drop through your foot, pull forward into a plank, chaturanga push-up. Lower halfway. Shift forward, upward facing dog. Downward facing dog. Nice deep inhale. Open mouth exhale. We'll start to move into that opposite side. Extend through the left leg. Toes are pointing down. Engage through the core. And on your next exhale, we'll crunch it forward, knee to nose. Inhale, extend. Exhale, knee to left elbow. Inhale, extend. Knee to right elbow, cross it over. Exhale. Inhale, extend. One big breath, big movement. Exhale, crunch it forward. Step it through. Find that nice low lunge. We'll drop into our back knee. Again, it's okay to keep those toes tucked under to give you some extra stabilization. As you're ready, taking whichever arm variation and rising up into our supported crescent. Finding strength in through that right side, in through the core. And as you're ready, sinking into your flexibility slightly. Finding that nice balance of strength and flexibility. Lifting in through the heart, staying nice and aware of your core, of your center. Keep the breath flowing. One more round here. Inhale. Exhale. We'll start to plant through the right hand. Left arm reaches up as we find a nice gentle twist towards the left leg. Gaze can look towards your left hand. And again, drawing that shoulder blade down flat against the back. One more breath cycle here. Exhale, sink a little deeper. And inhale, we'll rise up into a twist, keeping the arms exactly where they are and sinking back into that lunge. Option to look over at that left hand. Keep the breath moving. One more cycle here. Inhale. Exhale, start to plant the left hand right at the sacrum, and then lifting with the right arm up and back. Feel a nice stretch in through that right front hip. Keep breathing, keep lifting and opening through the collarbones as you breathe into the heart. One more breath cycle. And as you exhale, cartwheel the hands down. Frame that front foot. Extend through your right knee. Press into the hands. Find your three-legged dog once again. Take a breath here. Again, draw down through the hip. Inhale, shift your weight forward, plank. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, shift up. Exhale, down dog. All right, yogis. Feel free to wipe the sweat, grab a quick drink. We'll meet in downward facing dog, moving breath to movement. Sending those hips high. Nice deep inhale. Open mouth exhale. Inhale, look to the front of your mat. Exhale, step or hop your way into a forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, rise up. Gather all that good energy you've created through center. Pull it in. Hold on to it. Inhale, arms extend up. Draw the pinkies in, shoulders down. Exhale, sit low into your chair. Inhale, lift into the chest. Exhale, sit a little deeper. Inhale, lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. One big movement. Exhale, hop back. Flow through chaturanga. We meet in downward facing dog. Inhale, right leg extends. Exhale, crunch it forward. Inhale, extend. Knee to right elbow. Inhale, extend. Cross to left elbow. Inhale, extend. Exhale, one big movement. Crunch and step through. Drop down through that back leg. Inhale, lift into your crescent. Exhale, plant through the left arm. Inhale, twist. Exhale, rise to your twisted crescent. Sink a little deeper. Inhale, lift up and over. Exhale, cartwheel the hands. Extend through the right leg. Flow through chaturanga. Downward facing dog. Inhale, left leg extends. Exhale, crunch knee to nose. Inhale, extend. Exhale, left elbow. Inhale, extend. Exhale, right elbow. Inhale, extend. One big movement, crunch, step through. Inhale, we rise. Exhale, plant through the right hand. Inhale, find your twist. Exhale, rise up. Inhale, exalted, lift up and over. Exhale, cartwheel the hands down. Extend through three-legged dog. Flow through chaturanga. Knee in downward dog, nice deep inhale. Open mouth, exhale. Take a moment here. If you'd like to flow through that sequence again, feel free to pause the video and rewind it. If you're ready for the cool down, shift the weight forward. Tabletop. Take any gentle movements. And then we'll come into a nice gentle cool down. Shift the weight forward. Extend your feet in front of you. We'll take a really gentle forward fold to begin. Bring the legs out to mat distance for this fold. And it's okay to bend in through the knees. Lengthen the arms up, pull forward through the chest. Exhale, we'll reach out past the toes and round forward. Keep breathing in through the belly to really exaggerate that stretch in through the hamstrings. Let the chin come down to the chest. And breathe. Inhale, halfway lift, strike to straighten through the spine. Pull the chest forward. Exhale, round it forward once more. Inhale, we'll walk it all the way up. Hug the feet to touch each other and in towards the body. We'll take a butterfly pose. Flap your knees a few times. Press into one side. And the next. Just finding that sweet spot with the placement of your feet, pulling to lift through the heart, and exhale, we'll round it forward.
Sending the breath into the back. One more inhale here. Deeper exhale. Start to walk it up.
Grab a hold of the back of the legs. Make your way down onto your back. Feel free to take some windshield wipers. We did lots of twists today, so feel free to take any final little movements before making our way into our final poses here. We'll start to lengthen one leg up and then cross the ankle over the knee and hug for figure four. Keep the awareness of your right knee going away from the torso. You want to have outward rotation here. Keep breathing into the right side. Exhale, hug it in. We yourself one more squeeze and drop down. Cross it out and switch out your legs. Hug in on the opposite side, figure four. One more deep inhale, breathe in through the belly. Exhale, hug it in a little closer. Drop down through the feet. And you have some options for your final resting pose. You can come into Shavasana and just extend the arms and legs out to the corners of your mat. Or you can come into a reclined butterfly, letting the feet touch and letting the knees fall open. Just take a few moments to absorb your practice. Just letting the breath come back to its natural state. Thankful for your practice, for the time you set aside to dive deeper into your own body and your mind and your spirit, and to find that union . Begin to roll to one side. Take a moment there. Just inviting in some extra love and sending some love as well. And as you're ready, make your way up into a nice seat. Hands can come to heart center. Anjali Mudra, the mudra of compassion. Taking one more beautiful, juicy breath. Open mouth, exhale. The head bowed to the heart. Thank you so much for sharing this practice with me today, yogis. From the light in me to the light in each of you, I bow with gratitude. Namaste. See you next time.